धर्मार्था कामेभ्यो नमः। धर्म अर्थ और काम को नमस्कार है। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू इन टुडेज सेशन। एंड यू माइट बी वंडरिंग दैट व्हाई वन वांट टू स्टार्ट दिस सेशन विथ वर्शिपिंग धर्म अर्थ एंड काम ऑल टुगेदर। सो आई वुड बी टेलिंग यू दैट व्हाई आई हैव स्टार्टेड द सेशन लाइक दैट। But before that, I would like one favor from you, that you introduce yourself with your name, what you do, and what is the expectation you from this session, if you can just brief about that. Be seated, no problem.
Yeah. Okay, myself, Pandu Rathore.
Yeah.
I'm working in a manufacturing company as a quality control engineer.
Okay.
And from this session, maybe some got some tools so that I can apply in, on regular basis, maybe after the 10 days or the 1 year or the 5 years.
Yeah.
I can get to know what is my passion in profession.
Yeah.
So that, ultimately, everyone was saying that
Follow
your passion. Follow your passion.
Passion, yeah.
So that's
okay.
So I wanted to know this little bit, not
sure. As we started, right? Dharma, Artha and Kama. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Namaskar. I begin with that. So this was the first observation of mine to the today's world, that these are the three things which are, we can say, as the main factors, right? Any individual do some action, right? He is doing something, either he has some conviction about his dharma, that this is my mano dharma, I have to do this act, either he want to gain some wealth, artha, right? Or he has some desire, he has some kama, right? To summarize this, right? That any act is influenced by either dharma, or it is influenced by the desire of wealth, the artha, or it is a kama, right? So these are the three main factor, you can say, which provoke one, right, to do some act, to do some action, right? And if you try to see, right, this difference between these three, right? Dharma you put one side, and the artha and kama, right? So these two things seems entirely different from each other, right? So one is dharma and one is artha and kama, right? But if you try to think more about it, so these two things help each other, right? They support each other. So they are not very different, but they are supporting factor for each other. So we can say like that. So that was the reason I started this session with, that dharma, artha and kama ko namaskar hai, right? And about this session, this passion and profession, right? So if you have any goal to achieve, right? Either you are influenced by dharma, your beliefs, right? Or you have some desire to achieve some goal, in the form of wealth, or you have some other desires to fulfill, right? So you can achieve those goals by following your passion, right? Or whatever profession you are, right? By doing good in your profession, you can achieve those goals. So these are the, you can say, mediums to achieve any goal, right? So that was the reason. So, and when I say about this profession, let's begin with the profession, right? So last week when I was watching news, so there was a news about the Jet Airways. What happened in Jet Airways, that there was a lot of employees who have lost their job, and I was trying to see their faces, or what is going on in their inner being, right? As an inner being, what they are feeling, right? And I found that they were somewhere, most of the employees, which news channels were showing, that they were appearing like a helpless, right? They have no future, and they were worried about their, you can say, family, and their professional life as well, right? So that was the one, I can say, one observation I had. After seeing that, my conviction become more strong, right? Why one should have at least his one passion, right? One passion. What happened with the passion is that passion give you two things. It gives you a personal drive. First thing, it gives you a personal drive, it gives you a kind of reason that why I have to do something for my own, first thing. And if what happened with that is that if you are in this process, that you have some passion and you are very active physically, mentally, emotionally, right? You have some kind of goals for yourself, so you remain active and you remain little bit different from the crowd. What happened is that whenever we are in a journey, right, we remain very active. As a student, we were very active because we had some goal to achieve and we have some professional goal to achieve. Once we got some job or we were in the process of thinking about starting some business, own startup, right, and we were in that journey, but the moment we achieve your first 3 good years in business, we become relaxed. Or it happens in the same with the job also, that when we join some job, we have lot of enthusiasm, right, we have lot of passion towards it, but slowly and slowly it get down, and we from the active mode we shift to the inactive mode, we can say slowly, right? And this is the reason, right, when instead of we follow our passion, we slowly and slowly become dependent to the system we belong to, right? We depend to the job we do, we depend to the business we do, and if anything uncertain happen, which is not is according to our predictions, right, so we become very upset that, and we don't get an idea now what I have to do, because I thought that my journey is over now and I have to relax. In that mood I was, but what happened when the things changes accordingly, I become very uncertain about my life, and I get lot of depression, I can say, and all the negative feelings start coming, and I spread these things to my family, my surrounding, and everyone will say that this kind of life one should not live, the things go that deep, right? So, and that is the one reason I would say about this session, this passion and profession is trying to point out, you can say, right? So before we actually begin our session, that what is passion and profession I am going to discuss, we will be definitely discussing that how one can find out his passion and how he can follow his passion apart from all the obstacles, right? Or if you don't have any passion, how he can do his own profession more joyfully, right? He could live his life better. So that is the agenda of this session, right? And the question I would like to ask you before going further, that what is your understanding about passion? If someone asks you that what is passion and what is your passion basically, right? So what would be your answer if you can say that? One question to that, your answer, right? Sometime as a student, let's assume as a student life, I had some passion and I was willing to do willing to get a top position in my class, right? That was my kind of passion, that I have to perform better as a student. But does that passion remain same after completion of education also? Does that passion remain same after the completion also? Or you say that, so that, for example, I'm giving another example, that as a student you had some passion, you achieved that goal. So after achieving that goal, does that passion remain same inside you? Or it shifts from one passion to other passion? Yeah.
Actually, that's a goal.
Yeah.
If you want to that particular person, let's say, like, you want to study something.
Yes. So, yeah, you are very accurate. that to get the clear idea about the passion, right? What is my passion? How I know that what is my passion, right? So a lot of people say that I'm, because I meet with other people, so they say that I'm passionate about this, and I'm also passionate about this, and I'm also passionate about this. So I have two or three passions, right? This kind of people come, and some people come with answers like, I'm not very sure what I want to do, what I'm passionate about, but I want to do something, right? So this kind of people also come. But how to get a clear idea exactly what is my passion? Exactly what is my passion? If I want to know, then I need to answer two questions. First, write down what is my passion. Write down what is your passion, first thing. Then second question you need to answer is, write down why you want to live for. So first question was, what is my passion? And the second question was, why I want to live for? So answer for these two questions, right? If they are same, that what is my passion and why I want to live for, if the answer for these two questions are same, then identification of my passion for myself is very right. But if I have two answers, that I think that I am passionate about something, but when I ask myself that why exactly I want to live for, if the answer is something else, it means that I have not truly identified my passion, right? Because this answer could not be different. And if these answers are same, that one individual is in front of me, he is saying that this is my passion, I'm very sure, and this is the reason I want to live for. Yeah, long, right? So he has identified passion correctly, right? But then again, this passion has different states inside a human being, right? Two people have passion for singing, let's assume, but the state of passion will be different in these two individuals. How? I would say that passion can exist in any individuals either in the four states. First state would be, one individual will say that I am passionate about singing, let's assume, but I know that I don't take enough actions or I don't put enough effort for my passion. State number one, he thinks about it that he is passionate, but he don't put enough effort. He knows that. Second state would be that he know his passion and he put lot of effort towards his passion, but till now, after a lot of effort also, he has not achieved any goal in his passion. State number two. Third state would be that one identified long back about what he is passionate, right? And he has created something out of his passion, right? But after some point of time, that he is kind of static now. He is not able to bring his passion to next level. In other words, he has expanded some business up to certain level, but he's now, after 3 to 5 years, he is not feeling too much passionate about it, and he is not getting an idea how to bring it to next level, right? How to expand it. And the fourth and the most beautiful state, I would say, that one identify his passion, he is living his passion, and his life is full of joy. So these four states we can give. These four states we can give that passion could exist inside one. Right? Then again, what is the best thing for a human being? That what is the best state for a human being who has some passion? Right? That, for example, A person, state A I said, B I said, C I said, D I said, right? So what is the best state? Right? So if I want to compare a person who has some passion, either any of the states, A, B or C or D, right? And the other person who has no any passion at all. Other person who has no any passion at all. So this person who has some passion in any state, he is far luckier than a person who has no passion at all. Why? First reason for it is, and why I am so much convinced about it is, that person who has a person who has some passion inside, he live a life more purposeful, and he has more meaning to every act of his own, right? Whatever you do, he is able to correlate that why he is doing, and he has more satisfaction and joy inside. So with passion, you can say a person live a better life with more satisfaction, and he find more meaning to his journey. So this is the one reason that why passion is very much important for one individual, or I can say why one should follow his passion, or at least he should try to find out at least one passion for himself, right? And after that, this whatever the fact I have said so far, that with passion, right, an individual live better life, he remained more joyful. There was a scientific research for that. There was a town and there was a group of scientists, right, and they found something different in this particular town. In that particular state, there was multiple town, and this town where the scientists were interested was very different from the other towns. And what was the reason was that this particular town A, if I say this town A, most of the people were above 90 years of age. They were very long living, and when they dig further, right, they found that they live very joyfully when it comes to their day-to-day life. So they were long living, many of them were near 200 or more than 90, and at the same time they were very happy and joyful. Then they perform some medical test to them. They have done the blood test and so many other tests. Then they found some few similarities in these individuals. What were those similarities? First similarity they found, right, that in those individuals, we can say objects, those individuals, they found that they have a DHEA, this hormone was very high. And this hormone is being called a miracle hormone. It is a kind of hormone which our body produces when we do something very joyfully. When we do something which we really like, so this hormone get produced inside our body, right? And this body is responsible for once the kind of life we live. It means it increases our life if this hormone is more, and it continuously it means getting produced inside us whenever we do good things. So first similarity was that this hormone, the DHEA hormone, was very high in that. And when they dig further about their lifestyle, that what they do from morning to night, right, what they do, that there was a second similarity between these people, right, that they do at least one thing which they really like every day. They practice it passionately, right? Either it is a fishing, either it is a reading, either it is a writing, either it is a singing, anything, right? Any activity. These people were involved in some activity. So that was the second similarity. And out of this, all the research, they concluded this, that if one individual has some passion for himself and he actually live with that passion, right? So he increases his life, the quality of life, and he remain more joyful. So these were the two conclusions. But if you try to see the reality, today's reality, in the corporate world or outside the corporate world, what appears to me is that most of the people, let's take an example of your organization also, most of the people are not very happy with their own job, what they do. They are not very happy. Or they have some other reasons to do that. Because to do some act, right, I have a reason because I don't know something else to do. Something else to do, for survival at least I have to do. I have a family responsibility, so I have to do. I have my own career, I have to go somewhere, so I have to do, right. But with this thought process, if we do something, what happens is that we get stress. Because I know while doing that I don't like too much whatever I'm doing. Right. So after some point, I get some stress out of it, that I'm continuously trying to involve myself in the very act which I really don't like, and that is causing me a stress inside. And with that, the kind of hormones will produce inside my body will not be good for my health, right? My mental health, my emotional health, my physical health, right? It will slowly and slowly affect me in a negative way in the long run. And that is the reason why I see that a lot of people are physically fit, but they are not emotionally happy. They are not happy with the professional life, they are not happy with the personal life, and they have a lot of challenges. They have everything, but they have some kind of stress inside. And why? Because they somehow they want to do something else. They want to do something else. And what is the challenge when I say that I, one individual will come to me and he'll say that I know that this is my passion, right? This particular act I want to do, and I feel very happy whenever I do that. But there are some challenges. First challenge I can say is that more than 20 to 25 years of my age, right, I got trained in something which I really don't like, but I only have this training, and with this training I can only do a specific kind of job, and which is the medium of my survival. And if I think about my passion, I have no professional training, right? I have no professional training, and I think that I cannot make a successful career, or one could say that in this age I cannot take any risk, or one can say that he has a conviction inside that I know that I am about what I am passionate. He will say that I know that about what I am passionate, but he has a kind of conviction that I cannot do up to the mark, right? I cannot do this particular thing, right, in a way that I could earn enough. He has no confidence for himself, right? So this might be the reason, right? This might be the reason that one know that what exactly he want to do, or he also know that, for example, any profession he is, what exactly he want to do in that profession, where he want to see himself, but he has kind of fear inside to take challenges. And fear, if you say that fear, we can divide into two types. One are the known fears and second are the unknown fears. What are these types, right? Known fear and unknown fear. So known fear are those fears which we get out of our own experience, that I have some bad experience in my life, that I have tried something out of the scope in the past and I fell very badly. So that experience I am carrying in each and everything, right? That experience I am carrying, and this is giving me fear whenever I try something new. Known fear. Unknown fear are what? Right? Unknown fear are those that I have seen this world around, that lot of people tried for that particular thing which I am thinking to try. Let's assume one want to become a Formula race driver, right? He want to become like that, or he want to go for writing, or he want to go for any other career which is not trained, right? And he has seen lot of other people who has failed, who have tried similar to that, right? So this is the unknown fear. The out of others' failure, right, he is thinking that he will fail also because they have failed. But if you try to think about these two situations, right, there are two individuals, one who really want to do something and one who is not sure whether he want to do it or not. How they will see this world? Person A, who really want to do something, what he will do is he will try to find at least one individual out of this million, right, who has done that what he is willing to do. He will try to find the winner in that particular area. And another individual who don't want to actually do that, right, who don't want to actually do what he will try to find out, he will try to find out at least one person, at least one reason, right, who has failed. And that is that reference he want to take help, right, that reference that he has failed and that's why I don't want to try. So these are the two kind of mindset. Then if you try to move further in, that we have seen till now, that what is passion, and one knows that what his passion is, right, still he don't want to take chance out of fear. These are the challenges he himself. Then what is your understanding, can we conclude like that there are two kind of there are two possibilities, we can say that one person who either follow his passion, or he do something with lot of passion, right, either his profession or his own some hobby, right, he has no fear and he has no obstacles in life. Conclusion 1. Conclusion 2 is that one individual who has some fear inside, or he has some obstacles in his life, he cannot follow his passion, or he cannot do something with lot of passion. Can we conclude like that? What is your point of view, or what you think about it? That one who follow his passion has no fear at all, and who has fear, he cannot follow his passion. Whether you are agree with this or not, what do you think? Yeah.
If you have the possibility, then you will try.
Yeah.
If you don't try, then nothing will be happen.
Yeah.
If you want to try, then you will not find someone who has done something.
Yeah.
Then only your brain will be active.
Yeah.
Just, I think, it's a lesson in mind.
Yeah.
You motivated your mind by reading book or any.
Yeah.
Like any good.
Yes.
Yeah. So that you can achieve it.
Yeah. But I will make my question more specific. Actually, what I want to listen is that what is your answer in yes or no? One individual who has some fear inside, who has some obstacle in his life, he cannot follow his passion. The individual who has no fear at all and very less obstacle or no obstacles in his life, he can follow his passion. So what is your answer about A and B? That whether you are agree with this conclusion, I'am trying to conclude our discussion, entire discussion, that one person with no fear can follow his passion. Other person who has some fear, he can never follow his passion. What do you think about it?
Yeah,
yeah.
Suppose he wanted to, for survival, he wanted to do the job. He can continue the job and also simultaneously for his passion.
Yeah.
So this is the just the risk minimization.
Okay. So where I want to go from here is that I want to share something about me, that how I found my passion, and whether I have fear or not, I'll be sharing. And if I have a fear, how I deal with those fears? If I have no fear, how I came to this state? This will be the next agenda, you can say, for our further discussion, right? So what I am doing here today, that I am trying to speak in front of other, I am trying to give some, I am trying to share some experience of my life, right? This was not part of my career, you can say, or part of my education anywhere for a long time. I started my journey as a very, you can say, normal student. I was kind of average student, right? And I was completing my education. At that time, I have observed this in the society, that people around me who are very happy, they are very much settled in their career. They are economically well. And people who are not so satisfied with their life, they have not done very good with their career, and that's why they have some challenges. So that as a student, this thought went very deep inside me. And there at that moment, I took the decision that at any cost, I have to be very successful in my career. I have to get some good job, and I have to do very good in my profession. That was the first idea I got. With that thought process, I took science, right? After that, I completed my engineering, then my MBA, right? And I was doing my, education very good. And also, I got a job. And after doing this job for a few years, again, I started realizing my surrounding. So people reached to this state, right? Completed their education, reached to started their profession or the career, and they are little bit stable now in their life. From here, life moves towards two directions. What are the direction? You can say, first direction is, and this is the majority, I would say, that people who achieve something in their career, what they are willing for, and they are a settled life now, they accept this achievement as their world. Now their family, now their career, and now their social acceptability, right, is their world. And they live their remaining life happily with this, right? Say, they say that I find meaning for my life, and I feel that this is good for them who can accept. But there are very few people who get some different kind of experience. And what is the experience is that after achieving all these things, they realize that this is not exactly what I was willing for. They slowly and slowly started finding these things meaningless. They don't find too much interest in their financial achievement. They don't find too much deep connection in their family life. They don't find too much, you can say, social acceptability. They don't think too much about it. And this, when this happened with one individual, what happened is that slowly and slowly, he create kind of emptiness inside. He feel that I have achieved everything, but this everything is nothing for me now. I don't want this thing, I want something else. And in that state, what happened is, again, there are two categories we will find. One category, which we know very well, that after spending a lot of time in some other profession, people took decision, they take enough risk, right, and they start something new or become very successful, and they live their remaining life with their success and joy. But the number is very few. What others do is that they try to find something very good for them. And they also try to start, but they realize that it is some late. It is too late for them to begin a new journey. And this create kind of regret inside them at the time of death. That they die with some regret that I was willing to live that life, but I could not because of some reason. And that was the point where I started thinking that if one could not live the way he want, at least he should be able to die peacefully. One should die with no regrets. That was my goal to achieve. One should not die with any regrets, So that was the kind of formula I was trying to find out, that how it could happen. And then I started searching for that how it is possible, because a lot of people have lot of regrets, right, at the time of death, and that's why they try to do so many things that while living this world, but they don't get satisfaction. And then I realized the nature of life is that the way you live is the way you have to die. If you are not living your life with full of happiness, it is a myth that one can think about that he will die peacefully. It is the nature of your life which will decide the nature of your death. And if one is living with the regrets, right, he will die with regrets. And if one could live his life very happily, very joyfully, right, then he could achieve the peaceful death. So that was the kind of formula I got. But how to achieve that? Because we discuss that we begin with that dharma, artha and kama. These are the three factors which provoke one individual to do some action. The second point was that passion and profession are the two ways using which, yes, one could achieve his goal, either it is influenced by any of three, dharma, artha, and kama, right? But one could not follow his passion, or he could not achieve whatever he want to achieve in his profession because of the fear, the two kind of fears, the known fear and unknown fear. And then we concluded that if one has fear, he cannot follow his passion and he cannot do very good in profession, right? And one who has no fear, right, then only he can follow his passion and he can do very great in his profession, right? And this conclusion where we came, right, it is not very true, because if one want to do something out of his passion, for his own, you can say, then the number of obstacles what we have now will automatically increase instead of reducing, because you are trying to do something which we have not done so far. And what about the fear? You have fear for things which you already know. So then think about the amount of fear you will have when you will try something new. If I speak about myself, right, I have a lot of fear. I have a lot of fear. Every day I think that whether I would be able to achieve my daily goal or not. Whether I'm trying this, I'm investing here, right? I'm investing my time, I'm investing my money, whether I will get that fulfilled result or not. This kind of fear I have. And everyone, I believe that who follow his passion and who do something for his own, right, he gets some this kind of fear inside. But every day, whenever this fear comes to me, right, I say that fear that I'm not ready to accept you. I have to do something by crossing that limit. I have to indirectly, I can say that I have to kill that fear with my actions. My actions are the only way to kill the fears. Fear will always remain. Fear will always be there because there is uncertainty. Life is uncertain. So there will be always uncertainty. But one has to take actions against those fears. So our thinking that one will not have a fear and then he can follow. No. If you follow your passion, then only you can kill the fears. That is the one way of living. And then it comes whether I will be successful or not. If I do that, whether I'll be successful or not, that's the ultimate thing, right? That one want to do something to become successful. No one to do something for failure, right? So whether I will be successful or not, let's assume that I have decided that after 5 years, this is the goal I need to achieve in my career, or this is the goal I have to achieve in my personal life. And for that, first thing which comes into mind is that I have to invest my time, I have to invest some money, I have to invest a lot of energy into it, right? And after investing that, what will be the result? Right? That thought comes in everyone's mind. How to deal with the situation? How to deal with the situation? Whether one should follow the philosophy, the do your karma and forget about the results, that is not possible in the real life. Because if you invest 10 rupees, that we think about whether we'll get the right kind of particular return or not. We think about few rupees also. That we cannot think about that we cannot reach to the state in the very beginning. That after investing of my 5 year, I will be okay if I don't get any returns. That is kind of impossible thing for the beginner, right? Then how to do? How to deal with this, the process of success and the failure? Right? Because no one can say that if I am doing this, I will be 100% successful. No one can say that. No one can say. Why? Because this life is, whether I will be there tomorrow or not, I don't know. So no one can say that. Then how to deal with or how to cross this barrier? So to cross this barrier, what kind of solution I got is, replace this success with the greatness. Replace this success with the greatness. And what is the difference between this success and greatness is that if you get this belief that I have to do something very great in this world, so then first thing you will do is with yourself is you will forget about the number of success and number of failure in that journey, because now you are playing for the greatness. No matter how many times you fail, no matter how many times you get success, The success will not be not be able to satisfy you. At the same time, failure will not be able to kind of defeat you. You will create a mechanism inside that once you decide, right, that I have to live this life for the greatness. Once this comes into mind, right, all the vision, your goal, everything become very clear. And then you find a path where to go, or you create a path where you have to go. So one should not only think about if he is okay with the kind of success that one, this is my goal and after achieving this I will be happy, right? It is good for them. But if success is not satisfying you, or failure is hurting you too much, think about greatness. Because you can create something very great out of your life. And once you start living for your greatness, right, this journey is very different for the common life. What happens is, once you start doing this, you will remain in this world, but you will not live in this world. You will have your own inner world. Because you know very clearly where you are going. Inside. This, whatever the people around you will say something, right, about you, will not affect you. Because you will be listening yourself. So you will be in front of people, you will be listening their talk, but you will, where you will be living in your inner journey. The different kind of life. This taste of life is very different. Right? So what is the ultimate formula? What is the ultimate formula one should have? That one should have, that to live this greatness. So there are only two steps one have to follow. First thing is, find out what is that one thing you are really mad about? What is that really one thing which about what you are really, really mad about? You are mad about it, and that is your passion. And once you know that passion, right, what is the next step you need to do? Once you know that, what is the your madness, what is the next step you have to do is, you have to find a way to keep that madness alive inside you. You have to keep alive that madness inside you, and at the same time, with that madness, you need to work silently. You need to learn work silently. So first point is, find that one thing you are really mad about. And the second thing you need to do is, you have to learn work silently for that madness. Because this happened, right? That sometimes people become too, it means they start doing something and they are immediately they are trying to show that thing to the world. They try to show their results, they try to show, but that will not help for the longer journey. If you really want to do something great, which is possible, right, you need to find really what is that one thing which you really like and follow that passion. And if the question is about to come, that if what one can do or what I can do, that if my passion is not related to my profession. For example, I am in profession A, but I am passionate about something else. How this passion could help profession, right? So this was the question I got long back, that whether what is the way to become very sharp or very intelligent, whether I have to read 10 subjects or whether I have to focus on one subject. So my answer was at that time that if one could follow go very deep in one subject, definitely he will develop a kind of intelligence inside that whatever the subject he will touch next time, he will be able to go there also. And this is what passion does with one individual. What it does is that once you started following some passion, it means instead of your body and mind, you started working with your heart. You learn how to pure yourself entirely in something, doing something. That creates a different kind of nature of your, that can create a different kind of nature. That you become, you learn one art to work with your heart. Right? And once you become a different kind of person, right, anything you will do more joyfully. Because you develop a kind of nature that you are ultimately you are happy with your life. You know that whatever profession you are, this is not the ultimate thing. You have to do these things to follow your ultimate passion, to ultimate goal. So all the obstacles which were visible before, right? That these are my obstacles. They will become your helping hands, because your goal is so far and so big now, right? So that is the kind of summary I can give to this session, is that what one can do is that he should do those two questions, that he need to find one thing which he can call his passion, and the same thing he could say that this is one thing which for which I want to live for. Once the passion is there, he need to work silently. He has to, and it could be whether one has to follow some trainer, whether one need outer training or not, that whether what all things he can do, the journey will tell you. Your journey will tell you. Once you start your journey, right, journey itself will tell you that what exactly you have to take as a next step. What exactly you have to do as a next step. Journey is the only path. Without doing the journey, no one can give you. Without a journey, you may get a result. Without doing your own journey, you may get a result. But you will not be able to experience that results inside you. Indirectly, you will not be experience the happiness inside you, the kind of life. So that was the agenda for this session, right? And this was I was willing to say about passion and profession. If you have any more doubts, or if you have any goal to achieve which you want to discuss, this is my goal and how I will be able to achieve that goal in a given period of time, right? Or how I can make that my planning more better, right? Because everyone say, I will give one example about goal setting, right? People say that if I ask one individual that where you want to go in next 5 years, he will say, I want to become a VP in my organization, right? The next question I will ask immediately to him, that what is the task item you have to do today to reach your goal 5 years later? The task item will be missing. Then I will ask him that, okay, you are not doing anything today or tomorrow. What will be you will be doing after a week, after a month to achieve your ultimate goal? He will have no answer, or he may have. But are you certain? If you'll say that I am very much sure that this is the task item I will be completing by end of this month. So are you certain about that you will be completing? He will say 50-50, or he will say I am not very sure. It depends. Right? And this is what happened, that we decide a goal inside in our mind, but we don't plan very seriously about it. We don't plan very seriously about it. So if I have to set a goal inside, right? What is the first step about goal setting, right? First step about goal setting is know your present state, where you are, what are your challenges, and what are the things you have to resolve before actually you start working towards your goal. For example, you might have some economic dependency, financial dependency towards your family, right? And you might have some your own professional dependency or personal dependencies, right? So whether you are able to come out from those, at least can you put those things into automated mode so that you can find some more time for yourself and you can work for some other goal as well. Then once you decide that this is the goal I want to achieve, try to connect your passion with that goal, that whether I really like that or not, that kind of goal I want to achieve, whether I am, that goal will demand something from you, right? You have to take some action. So whether about that action you are passionate or not, second thing, right? Once you know that, achieve that divide that 5 year goal into first 5 year, and then take the first year, and then divide the first year into 4 quarters like the companies do, let's assume, and create a project plan for yourself, that this is the first quarter, right? And this first quarter I will be achieving this much, and this first three quarter, the first quarter which have 4 months, right, divide 1 month, and then a week, and then day. So it means if you are working very seriously for your goal, you asked, right, that how you can achieve your goal into your career or any passion you have, right? This is the way I know which really helps. Before sleeping tonight, I would be knowing that tomorrow morning what I have to do. I should have a task item. That will help me in two ways. It will help me to achieve what I want to achieve, and it will also help me to do those things which really I don't want to do, but I will be doing those because I don't have to do anything else. You are getting my point. There are many things we do throughout the day which we later think that was not needed at all. That was not needed at all, right? Let's assume, take an example of 2 days weekend. People have 5 days working and they have 2 days of weekend, Saturday and Sunday holiday. And this Saturday and Sunday, Monday they think that what they have in Saturday and Sunday, right, was absolute nonsense. It was not needed at all. But why they have done? Because they have no plan what to do. And every time I say, right, one who learn this art, right, one who learn this art, how to set goal and how to achieve those goals, they become employer. One who don't know how to set goal and how to achieve those goals, right, by their regular effort, remain employee. This is the one difference. That what is needed? Once you set the goal and you know how to achieve that goal, you learn the business, you learn the very art. But one who don't know, right, one who don't know to identify the goal and then write a plan for that goal and to achieve that goal will remain same. He will be keep talking about this, that I want to do this, I want to do that, but he will never achieve anything because he has not learned the art. And I said about the success and greatness, about success and greatness, my philosophy is that anyone who is alive can become successful. Any individual who is here, right, he can become successful if you put real effort. But the result he will get out of that success will be temporary. But when he is ready to die for something, one who is ready to die for his passion, right, will become great, will achieve greatness. That whether you are able to put the kind of effort that you are ready to die for it, right? If once you will do something, right, with that limit, the kind of life you can experience. That is the only way to experience life is to if you are ready to die, right, you are putting all your effort to its max limit, right, you will experience the real joy of life. So it is not about this passion and professionalization is not only about that whether I will get my goal or not, whether I would be able to I'll become successful or not. It is about the kind of experience one could have in his life. It is about experiencing life, that how one can experience his life better, no matter how many years he has, no matter how much wealth he has, right, the inner experience, how we can design his life very well, right? If you try to see your daily routines, right, if you try to see daily routines and if you try to introspect what you do day to day, you will find that those things are enough, what kind of activities you engage yourself, those activities are enough to tell you that why you have something which you have. It means whatever your results are, right, they are outcome of your act only. There is no wonder outside. And what you think that something which I don't have, you are not putting enough effort, and or if you are putting effort also, those are the outer efforts. You are not completely entirely involved in that. So to close this session, ultimate thing is this: find that one thing where you can pour yourself entirely, you could put your life into it. Do you have something? Once you find that, start putting your life into it. That will change you as a person, that will change you as an individual, and then anything you will do, right, it will become great. It will become great. Fear will always be there, but it is your passion and your actions, right, which will kill the fear every day. every day will have big fear because you will be doing big things every day. But the more you will act, slowly and slowly you will not eliminate the fear from your life, but you will learn or you will develop an art that how to deal with this fears and go ahead in life. So that was my session, and that was I was willing to share, I share. If you have any further question, you can ask, otherwise we can wrap up this. Yeah, how to?
How could I find my way?
Yeah.
Means I can say that from past experience, there are some things which for which I'm really passionate about.
Yeah.
First one is reading.
Can you note down those points? Yeah. First one is?
First one is very, very important, which I really like to, that is reading.
Reading.
Something. Yeah. That is.
First thing is reading. First, we'll note down the point, then we'll discuss about it. First is reading. What else? Yeah, anything. It could be anything. Yeah. What else?
Second is fitness.
Fitness.
Yeah, I used to work out every day.
Yeah. Fitness. What else?
And third one is my need. I just wanted to be financially free.
Financially free.
I could have gotten something like passive
amount,
so that
wealth.
Because I explore my view, wealth
yeah.
is just a tool. It's not an anything. It's
yeah.
a tool which means
to achieve this truth. Can you say?
Yes.
Okay. So these are the three. Anything else
no,
you feel as a passion?
These three only thing I have.
These three. So first thing you said it is reading, second thing is a fitness, third is a wealth.
Mm.
Right? And you are not how you want to choose. Out of these three, you want to choose one thing which you can say, this is my real passion. Am I correct? Or you have some other thoughts?
Yeah, that is really only. That was the priority.
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 Yeah.
Priority.
Yeah. It always happens. It always happens if you try to think also. In your family also. That let's assume in your family there are five members and you have a connection for every member because someone is your father, someone is sister, someone is brother. But in family, we have some close relation with either with our brother, either with our mother, either with our father. So we find some connections. So, and what will happen is that if one has so many choices, right? That he is also interested about reading, he is also interested about fitness, he is also interested about wealth. Okay? Then what he will do is, according to my understanding, that I will discuss, I am just starting a discussion, then we'll reach to conclusion, right? And better you don't write, we'll do the discussion, then you can note down the points, right? So, if I am in your place, how I'll answer myself? That what could be the ultimate thing? For my, where I can put my life, your question was, right? What could be the ultimate thing where I can put my life? Because I want to remain fit. I want to get some wealth because that is the tool. And I also want reading, right? So, if I want to improve by using these tools, you said wealth is the tool, right?
Yeah.
I say my choices are my tools. To grow myself. My choices itself are my tool to grow myself. I want to read. I like reading because either I get some pleasure out of it, right? Either I get some pleasure out of it or I have some goal to achieve. After reading, either I only read for pleasure, I like to read stories. Right, I feel joyful inside, or I have some goal to achieve which I feel that I can get out of reading. Right, fitness, right? Same again, I have some pleasure or I have goal to achieve. Wealth, I want to be rich again, I want to feel that I want that I'll be happy or I have some goal to achieve. Right, I'm trying to divide these things, right? You, this thing I am thinking is a tool for one individual growth, right? And these tools, either I can choose for pleasure or goal, right? So if I ask you now that whether you like reading for pleasure, and answer me honestly, or you feel that after reading you will become something or you'll know something and you could achieve something.
Actually, it's both, sir. I like pleasure also, but pleasure more, and another one is goal.
Goal also, yeah, you have to achieve. Right? So this is one thing I can say, where you like both. That you have goal also and you like this also. What about this fitness?
It's only pleasure.
One. What about this?
Goal.
So you can say this is your goal, this is your pleasure, right? This is your pleasure and this is, right? This is your pleasure. So there are two things, right? One is need and one is wish. One is need and one is wish. Let's assume that fitness, right? Fitness. I know that without fitness, whatever I'll achieve by reading, I would not be able to enjoy it. Without fitness, how much wealth I have, no matter, does not matter. I would not be able to achieve. So fitness is kind of must thing that I have to remain healthy. I have to remain healthy, right? So this is kind of need. You and your mind both know. Anyhow, you say that this fitness gives you pleasure, but you know that subconsciously or consciously that without fulfilling this goal, this have no meaning at all. This have no meaning at all, right? So this is kind of need, you know, and you don't have, and one more thing, that you do for pleasure and you don't have any goal, it means you don't want to become a kind of celebrity who is utilizing his body, the kind of shape he has, for professional gain. So you are very clear on this. This is not your goal. This you do for pleasure because this helps you to enjoy these two things, right? So this is kind of helping hand for you. This is kind of sub goal for you or sub passion for you, I can say. So this we can put to point number two. Then I have two things. So if I ask you, right, you want this reading, right? So you want this reading to gain wealth. What is your answer? If you say goal, see, this goal could be a economical goal also. Because ultimately you want to become something which you are not today.
Yes.
Or you want to know something which you don't know today.
Yes.
So you want to know something or you want to be something to achieve something,
yes,
which you don't have today.
Yes.
It is kind of, and when I say wealth, it is not only the money. It could be anything. It could be kind of someone is very much passionate to become a celebrity in front of others. He want to show his intellectual abilities or his knowledge to others, that what I know nobody knows in my surrounding. Could be also kind of wealth. Yeah. So can you correlate this, that you want to read because you want to get some kind of wealth? I can say yes, right? And then this wealth, if I give the amount of money you dream about, if I give the amount of money you dream about, but in one condition, that you have to stop reading for forever. Can you do that? No, you cannot do that, right? Then what is your passion? What is your passion? Reading is your passion, right? If you will read well, you will be happy, you will exercise well. And once you are reading well, you are very fit, this will automatically follow you. If one has this passion, right, if one has this passion, right, then this will become the drive for him, wealth. Until and unless he'll get money, he will do these two things. The moment this will stop coming, he will stop doing this too as well, right? So this is your passion, and this you have to stick to it, because this is your passion, right? You have to stick to it, and you have to give variety to it. Don't stick yourself for reading one kind of book. Don't stick yourself for reading similar kind of reading, right? Give this a variety. This is your tool. Once you will do that, right, it will tell you how much you have to exercise. It will tell you how you will get money, right? So maybe you can, for now you can do, best thing I said is journey is the path. And journey is the only thing which can tell you that what is real for you, what is your truth, right? For now, I can see that reading is your passion. And read how much you can read, right? And this will follow, this will follow, and this will also follow once you are happy. So reading you can consider as your passion, I believe. And reading will give this two things to you automatically. And if one mistake we do is, right, sometimes what one can do is that I also want to remain fit. I want to give a specific goal or a specific kind of, I have to reduce 5 kgs. I have to get 6 packs. This kind of goal people set, right? And they also want to achieve some kind of goal here in reading also, that I should be knowing this many things after year, right? And I would be getting this amount of wealth, right, at the year end, right? So what will happen is, what is possible thing is, if I try to set goal in 3 places, my energy will be distracted somewhere. Whenever I will be reading, I'll be not very happy, because I'll be thinking about this. Whenever I will be achieving this, I'll be thinking about this, that I am reading enough, I'm getting this, but I'm not very fit now because I have this goal also. So my idea which I follow is, stick, make one goal as the first and supermost goal, super goal you can say, and take other things as a supporting hands. Everything I have to do, but why I'm doing all this? To achieve this. So that will give you a perfect direction. That will give you a perfect direction. And it will help you to waste your energy in different places. Whenever you will be reading, you will be reading. Whenever you will be exercising, you will be thinking about the reading, what I read today, right? Whenever you will be achieving wealth, you will be happy that I read this and I grow myself inside. That's why I am achieving this. Ultimate thing is, so don't two things, right? Keep your first passion or the most thing which you like, right, keep as a higher priority. And don't think this as a obstacles, that if I'll put half an hour or 1 hour for exercise, I'll not be able to read, right? Those kind of contradiction don't create inside you. These are helping everything you need. This also in, this also in, this not in. But don't set goal for all three. Keep one goal, keep one passion and one goal. Remaining thing you will get as a byproduct. So that is my understanding. You can think more about it, right? And we have also our mail ID, right? You also have our number. If whenever you have get some question like that, right, you can do one exercise for us, right? You can write down that one goal you want to achieve, right? This you can take as a assignment, you can say one goal you want to achieve out of your reading till this 2019, this year end, right, December, you want one goal you want to achieve. And then you write down that how you are going to achieve that, what is your plan for that, right? You write and you can send an email to us, right, email to me, yes. And then I will tell you that how you can improve that particular plan, and I will say that this plan is very perfect, or you can remove these things, right, and you can add these things. What we can work upon that we can do, figure out, right? And by doing this goal, what you have written, that how you will how you will achieve or how much you will achieve, the basic idea, right? By doing this, ultimately you want to achieve this also, right? So how much you will be able to make and how? Because this will again, if this is not the second goal, this will give a too much inner force and too much, this will bring the dedication inside you. For example, if you have a kind of reading and the clarity about what I have to get out of that reading, you will become more connected to your reading. You will become more connected and you will become more serious about it, right? So write down one plan for yourself today itself. Today is a Sunday, right? Today only you write down and you mail me that, and then we will work upon it, that how you can make it better. And then once you will do for 1 year, then we'll make it for 5 years, then we'll make it for 10 years. If these two steps I'll tell you, right, 1 year, 5 year, 10 year, then you can, you'll be able to enough. If you'll do this three exercise, right, you'll be able to write a plan for anything, for at least for you yourself. This exercise we can do, right? So we have discussed today that what is the importance of passion and what is the importance of passion in any profession. People get distracted, right? They get disturbed. How I can follow my passion? How I can follow my passion because it is not my profession, right? Whether if I'll try to follow my passion, I will get distracted from my profession. It is not true. It is not true. One thing you do very good, one thing you do very good, you become good actually. And once you are good, right, you do everything very good. Your efficiency will increase in anything you will do, right? So in that way you can write out. So write down a goal, write down your plan, 1 year goal you want to achieve out of reading, what all you want to read, how many books you want to read, what kind of learning you want to do, right? What kind of knowledge you want to get, and out of that learning, what you think that today you can achieve in 1 year. What we will do is, together, what we can do together is that we will try to double it twice, because it is your thinking, right? It is your thinking that you can achieve this much. I will be telling you, you cannot only achieve this much, you can achieve this much. Can we push it? Can we push it? And why we are doing this? Not for this, not for this, not for this. To experience this life better. If I'll do more, something which I really like, simply I'll be experiencing life more. So why I could not experience 5 years of life in 1 year? So that I can think about something for the next year. Can I do that? So I have your mail ID, I believe, right? I have your mail ID, and I would be expecting that till tonight, right? You are sending one mail to me, right? And then we will create a plan out of it, and we will work together for it, right? And we'll try to achieve. We'll not try to achieve. We'll achieve it. First we will make it clear that, for example, I am saying it, we can do double. It is my assumption, but you will say this is the reality. That you are thinking that every day I'm putting 3 hours, but I cannot 3 hours, I can only put 1 hour, or I can put only put 1.5 hours. So then we'll come to a mutual agreement that this is what we are deciding for this year, and we'll work closely upon it. I'll be taking updates for that. I'll be giving my input to that, and you can also giving me a response that this thing you suggested, but they did not work for me. Can we suggest something more? Can we suggest something different? In this way, we can utilize this entire process which we have heard about, right? So this is what we have discussed. If anything more you have, any more doubt, you can ask. But definitely send that mail. Definitely send. We'll write down the plan and we'll work upon it. No issue at all. Yeah. 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 And what is the way of writing, right? Take a paper, start writing. Don't think whether it is possible, not possible, start writing. Whatever comes into your mind, right, write down everything. It might be 1 page, 2 page, 3 page, write down everything and send me. Then we will decide that how to approach that. How to approach that. Ultimately, after attending this session, right, if I next year I come here, you should be a different person. You should be a different person. Why? Because we are saying that we know the process to achieve the greatness. So at least with the process of greatness, we should achieve the success, first success for our journey. That will only make sure, that will only validate whether my learning is right or not, or whether I have some assumptions and I think that this thing will work. These mistakes people do, right? They have some assumptions inside and they think that these things will work, and when they try, that they never work, and they feel that this process entirely, that I can, it means when one's process does not work, they feel that I'm not good enough to do something. So it is not the mistake of individual, it is the mistake of process, or the way they have applied the process. Or for example, in first year itself, one has a goal to achieve 10 crores. What is the current amount he has is 10,000. So whether this goal itself is right or wrong, and what is the way you have to achieve, make 10,000 to 1 crore or 10 crore, right? So in that way we'll think. So you note down that, and in that number, right, you have your number. So I'll be sending mail to you, and that mail you can reply, and then we can work upon that word. So yeah, so that's the thing for today. If anything more you have to ask, you can ask, else we can, any kind of doubt you have, or you have some other, yeah. Yeah, so we have a page, Success to Samadhi is our Facebook. Success to Samadhi. Yeah. There I write my quote and I write blogs. There you can put your questions. Success to Samadhi. That is my website also. That is my Facebook page also. And so there you can post your question. I'll be sharing a mail where you can reply. So there also you can connect. We have our number also. So you can take an appointment, you can ask your questions. If you have any point, for example, we decided that this week I'll be working, but after 3 days you come to know that these things are not working at all, right? I started this book, but I don't like how to replace, what is the best book, right? I choose these 5 books, but I don't feel good. Can you suggest some other book for the same subject? Do you know something? Any question, I'm giving you just an example, what kind of questions you can ask. So that is my page. You can like that page, right?
Yeah, I want to know the number.
Number is there in that page itself. It is there. Once you reach to that page, right, the number is there. And anyway, I'll be sending a mail from my mail ID, and in that mail you can reply. Right? So that's it. Anything more you want to know? Yeah. Okay, then thank you.